images of it. It was just a blank room. Like, cool, we can hang stuff up. That, like, the weekend before we moved in, they're like, by the way, they put in the wallpaper. And it's just all these ghostly characters.
Yeah, it's weird.
It's really weird, and I really want to cover it with stuff real bad.
I've already started with other ghostly people, but
yeah, that didn't help.
A loser called Susie reenacted.
Oh, yeah.
Adam getting
the
bash with a prick.
Yeah. I rewatched that part from time to time. It's
which,
really
which happened to me when I was playing my.
You got bricked?
I was like, damn it.
Yeah. Wolfgang on DeviantArt continue to do that. The Funhouse crest on a shield.
God,
that, needs, that needs to go to the House of Thrones image. They need to put all those together. Yeah. Absolutely.
God damn it.
I actually want that made.
So okay many talented people.
Going, right?
I want to hang it on a, like a, over a fireplace.
We need a contact.
We need a
blacksmith.
We need a fireplace.
Connor Daw on DeviantArt. He's been doing these portraits for a while, collected them all into one giant image.
Mm-hmm.
We all have been vectorized. James looks like character from Beetlejuice.
I look like the man who laughs.
Manton
who laughs.
I don't know what that is.
It's the inspiration. The original inspiration for the Joker is an old silent film called The
That's
Man
right.
Who Laughs.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, we need to do a banner for our YouTube page.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah.
That might be it.
I was talking to Lawrence about that. He brought it up right when I had the idea as well.
You
I was thinking when we move offices, we should
dirty
change
fat
it.
Heads. I like our dirty fat heads as the
banner. Oh, those are really good.
Dirty fat heads is pretty good.
Oh, yeah, dirty fat heads.
Which one's dirty fat heads?
Dirty fat
the
heads.
The center.
Right oh,
there. Oh! I mean, it's so good. I love it.
Sorry. We all look like we're about to explode.
Perfect.
And it's time to go to the Peak Corner. We're starting to get some more Matt Peak fan art. Panagok and Hannah.
I love
such a good drawing of Matt Peak.
Sneak a peek at Matt Peak.
Man.
Thank you.
That sexy son of a bitch.
Right?
This looking good.
It's
she somehow got the picture the one time he showed up on camera.
It's weird. Good fan art makes me appreciate that I know these people in real life.
Have we met Hannah? In real life?
No. Sorry, I mean the people in the art. So like, just looking at this, I'm like, man, I'm glad.
I was
I'm
like,
Matt's
I don't think you've met
good
Matt.
Good for Matt.
You're like, no, but
great art. Good for Matt. Good to know you, Matt.
That's weird to say, but it's true. Landrew1385 on Reddit.
Oh yeah.
This one. Matt Peak peeking in.
Matt editing and also slinging a peek in.
Yeah, that is a Matt Peak.
Yeah.
Oh, whoa! I never realized that.
That was during our Drunkborn recording.
Drunk
right?
Souls.
Drunk Souls. Darkborn.
Yeah.
I just imagine we were being loud, belligerent assholes, and Peach
is like, "Peach is like, fuck."
Yeah. Can they shut? I'm sure he came into Dallas.
What
quiet.
I'm really looking forward to actually, because Peach and I sit outside of this office now, and when we were in the other temporary office, it was just the two of us in a room, and so Peach would get really upset when he was editing. Like, what the fuck is going on?
Yeah.
Fuck you! And he would get up and like scream at Premiere.
He's a bit of a reaction.
We're outside with all the full screen now, and I can't wait for all the full screen babes to see this volatile editor screaming at his computer and call HR. It's going to be very exciting.
To be fair, Premiere crashes a lot.
A lot.
So.
Yeah. I don't blame Matt Peak.
No, I don't either. I love it. It's endearing.
He gets angry, but I don't blame him.
I'm passionate.
And finally, Jessica Canna. Hold on a minute. Canna Gillingham.
There you go.
Boom. Just the Noob on Twitter produced an Insight Gaming animated.
Whoa.
With cute little...
You mean Funhouse?
Yes.
Oops.
Funhouse animated.
We know what you
meant.
We know what you
meant. Jesus.
Yeah,
it's
right?
called...
I've done that a number of times.
Unfortunately, we can't hear it, but it's...
We all watched it earlier.
Yeah. It's Jack and... the Bear.
Oh, the gold... So, was this done with a third-party program, or did she do this from scratch?
Well, it has... graphics there on the wall,
and you guys look similar to who you are.
Yeah.
Well, she's actually been releasing images of your character models for the past couple of weeks.
Oh, okay.
And she always said like, I'm making these for a project. Look forward to the project.
Okay.
So I was, and here it is. So hopefully we'll see some more because it was a lot. It was actually animated pretty well.
I really like that.
Yeah.
Really cool.
More freaking power to you.
Thank you, Jessica.
You aren't a new.
What is?
You are, in fact, talented, a veteran at your craft.
You're awesome. Thank you.
And that'll do it
Bye,
for
Joel.
This episode of Dude Soup.
Goodbye, Joel.
I hope you guys enjoyed all of our Halo talk of what you could hear. If you'd like a separate podcast that we could do every week where I just talk about Halo, let us know in the comments.
I just talk about Tolkien.
Those are both canceled.
I just want to talk about Halo.
Master Chief finished his 2,000th pull-up and thought... I am so hung right now. I'm going to go bang Cortana.
You mean hung because he's finished the pull-up?
Yeah.
No, the key to writing good Halo fanfic is you have to add other pieces of,
other
like...
heroes.
I'm saving that for volume 13.
Oh no! The Halos overran the Earth! Doc Brown, we've got to go back to the future!
Cortana, my penis, you shouldn't!
Oh, it feels so good!
I'm so scared but aroused!
You guys are dicks. We're not gonna do true mouse and keyboard support because you need a controller because it's just We're doing X and A. Fuck it. Here's your game. And it, I think it sold. It had to have sold well. Because then the Dark Souls 2 release was like straight on PC. They're like, here it is. I think it was delayed like by a week. Whew. But the fact that they launched it on PC.
The first one required like a really big like kind of like user created mod pack too to like make it so.
Yeah, the DS fix and a few other things. Yeah.
Our enemies will fall. Death to all who oppose us.
Well, I was saying that we could start the podcast.
Oh, sure. Yeah, let me just get to that boss one more time.
Ooh, that's close.
I took my hand off the controller. That's how casual this is.
How vain Joel is.
Bruce, I don't even want to look.
Bruce called me Lawrence earlier. It was funny.
What were you saying?
Go to the tape.
How does that make you feel, Adam?
I don't care.
No, I'm serious. What was your first reaction? It was probably revulsion, right?
I actually, for whatever reason, and this isn't a, I don't know what it is, but I always get Joel and Lawrence mixed up.
I think we started the podcast right now.
Yeah,
I think
sure. We're both.
I want to get to the boss one more time.
Welcome, everyone.
Please don't.
To a burning
podcast.
Alcoholic bowl of dude soup. Sit the fuck down.
Once you lied, you flushed the toilet.
Joel, get in here. You flushed the toilet? What the fuck?
Joel. So it's actually a very delicate social problem. I believe firmly that California's running out of water.
We're doing a podcast.
I'm just playing.
He just rolled his eyes.
He just became his dad for like 2 minutes.
I can't stay in here for an hour and do a podcast. 6 o'clock.
Get in
it's
here.
6 o'clock.
It's 5:55.
I'm leaving in 15 minutes.
All right, we'll hold. Oh, you died real quick.
Right, what the fuck?
Let's talk about the topic.
Let's open up the podcast with a shot.
Okay, everybody's probably really confused.
We need
45 seconds of relative calm. Well,
welcome to the fun.
Oh, wait, you died.
Podcast.
You died. Fuck it. All right, it's time for shots.
Are you sure you don't want to start and stop?
No, we don't.
No, fucking hell. You're
I'll
really going
to
have an 8-hour
We should do a clap thing. We never did a clap thing.
Oh, shit. You're right. Fuck me. All right.
How many shots have you all done?
That's Adam.
Not a lot.
Oh, it is Adam.
I'll go to the menu.
No, wait.
I'm collapsing on this.
Hold on. What time are we at?
1:16.
Hold on.
1:17.
This is gonna be the fucking.
Wait.
That never works.
I know it never works, but I'll do it anyways. Oh, I'm spilling vodka.
All right, Adam, you ready?
Hold on. I'll do the clap sync here first.
What are you gonna press? Down.
X. Just gonna start the game.
You should press down because it does an animation. Or you just press left or right or whatever.
Oh, press down. Ready?
Ready? One, two, three.
Press down. I pressed down.
That was earlier.
Oh my gosh!
Where's James' shot? I don't know.
I don't have a shot.
All right, shots.
Wait, all right, on. James needs a shot.
Let me explain this to all of our listeners because they have no idea what the fuck's going on.
Yes, they do.
This is.
Wait, do I not get a shot?
Hold on.
Oh.
This is immediately
drunk.
Oh, spilled vodka all over your pants.
It'll evaporate quickly.
I wonder what Dana's gonna think.
It doesn't leave a stain, or an odor. Vodka's great that way.
Vodka.
Drunkborn, everybody.
Drunkborn.
So this
Drunkborn.
Is this oh, podcast right. is yeah, immediately okay. following our Drunkborn recording.
Hey,
and we are persisting it through the podcast. So every time Adam dies in the playing of this podcast, we will all take a shot.
I think we're gonna switch it up a little bit. So we're gonna.
We are?
Well, yeah, I would like you guys to play too.
Lawrence should play.
Joel, move a little to my
There's
right.
No,
there you are.
I'm missing a shot glass.
You're never gonna hear me in the mic.
Is that one?
That
was part of our alcohol enema strategy.
Ugh. Lost all my souls.
So, thank you for attending this very chaotic episode of Dude Soup. What just hit the keyboard?
There's a lemon seed.
In your lemonade?
Spray
that. Diet Coke.
What?
All right.
I put lemon in my Coke Zero.
What's our first topic?
Our topic for this podcast is drunk porn and how attractive.
Like, come on!
No, it's today we're talking about how much casual garbage Bloodborne is.
Yeah, it really is.
It's actually
casual garbage. So how long?
Into the podcast.
You've been playing it for an hour and 20 minutes, and we've done what?
Six.
I think Dark Souls 2 were 12. I want to say.
And there are no cuts. Like there was one cutscene at the beginning, and there was one forced death that Adam had to die at because all he could do is push the monster.
Yes.
But since that point, Adam's been fucking wrecking the game.
I've stood here for 20 minutes.
Not really wrecking.
All right.
How many did we do though for Dark Souls 2 that time?
Let me be an MC for a second. All right. Let me set this up for the audience, by the way, because they're probably really mad and they're skipping down to the comments and saying that we're terrible people for insulting Bloodborne. Here's the deal. Bloodborne is actually not casual garbage. Adam is actually just displaying his experience with From Software.
He's very good at it.
Action RPG.
I got pretty far in Dark Souls 1, and then I played a little bit of Dark Souls 2, and then it got a little too.
Adam's a smart player, and this game is very much a Dark Souls game. You can kind of.
And you missed a lot.
I'm very drunk.
So here's the deal with this game. It's kind of interesting. The combat's faster and easier to approach, as far as I can tell from Adam's playing.
Yeah.
There's some pretty interesting mechanics as far as life and
I like
recovery.
The combo system, like this thing, and then you whip it out.
That's really cool.
The one thing that is really casual about it is they give you health potions.
They drop a lot of health on you.
Like balls. Candy. Like they give you them for every.
See, look, he gets his life back though. That's cool, huh?
Yeah, did I?
Lord's right. So if the bar goes down, but the red bar doesn't go down, then if you hit another,
it's like red health and Marvel.
It encourages you to put yourself in danger and be aggressive.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, well,
which I like.
It reminds me a lot of Metal Gear Rising, and that it doesn't have a block, but your best defense is good offense, really.
Well, so Adam, Metal Gear Rising had a block, but it was next to impossible to use.
No, it had a parry, and you had to use it. What are you talking about? That's how
I don't.
No, there should be.
There, yeah.
I thought there would be.
So, Adam, if you take a hit, if you look at your life bar, you'll have red health that you get back if you start hitting the enemy that hit you or any other enemy. Yeah.
So, I didn't get any health there?
Well, so you look at the end of your life bar, there's that little white marker. Nice.
I'm the hero.
Valiant. If you get hit, that white marker will skip down, but your red health will not go down as far as the white marker does. Yeah. Once you get out of combat for a little bit, then the red health will go away. If you are still in combat and you hit your enemy, you will recover
some
of your
red. This is really boring for anyone just listening to the podcast.
It's a podcast. We're talking about Bloodborne.
This is not. So Joel, please don't stomp all over everything I just said.
Yeah,
I'm not stomping on what you said. I'm stomping on the fact that I appreciate and try to keep in mind our audio-only participants.
This is for the audio-only participants, Joel.
We're talking about the mechanics of Bloodborne.
Yeah.
We're on fire!
Torchman, you're dead! Defeated all progress. Torchman, coming at you!
I will say this. Sorry.
I've always said I was a Torchman. Didn't I say that?
I will say this. It is a lot like Dark Souls in the sense that you will underestimate certain enemies and be like, oh yeah, it's just a dude with a torch. I'll just take him on. And then...
Torchman, coming at you.
Oh, sorry.
It does have...
No, wait. Oh, yeah.
That is mine.
Who wants to take over, by the way?
I'll grab it.
You do it.
Lawrence will take a little bit.
Drunkborn.
I was actually really excited to participate in Drunkborn until you started at 5 o'clock and I have to drive home eventually.
Well, actually, a little bit of info for you guys there, too. Today, technically, so this is a Monday, this was supposed to be our very first live stream for Rooster Teeth. And unfortunately, we found out a little too late that there's an embargo.
Yeah, sorry about that, guys.
We have a retail copy of the game. We didn't get a review copy. We got the game early, came in, and... Yeah. No, we have to progress the save.
No, you should have come back to your save.
I was trying to. I didn't think I was going to die that early.
I'm pretty sure
Torch Man.
Regardless,
I always said you can't trust the Torch Man.
Torch Man coming at you.
We would have streamed this, except there was a fairly tight embargo.
Kind of KQXR, Torch Man.
Well, right now,
92.3, Torch Man. Torch Man and the douche. Torch Man playing Incubus. Squeeze one out with Torch Man.
So,
remind me to talk about the Rancid costume.
He's a giant baby wearing a diaper. What are you, Torch Man?
So, what's that? Oh, that's the ladder.
Let's check it out. So, if any of our listeners are, where does it go?
Go up.
Oh, that's right. We're up here. Yeah. If any of our listeners are curious about Bloodborne, it does seem to be a more
casual.
Yes, casual.
Garbage.
No, I would say.
Look at my nose.
That's not your nose.
I think that's how far the nose goes.
You're like an old doctor. A Renaissance doctor.
Well, no, because what was that movie? Interview with the Wolf. What's that French movie?
Yeah. Right. Oh, yeah. Brotherhood of the Wolf.
That's the one. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And they're all wearing the.
It's a fucking awesome movie.
Yeah.
Underworld.
Vincent Cassell's in
Underworld.
That.
Exactly.
Adam, were you ever hitting that button?
Brotherhood of the Wolf.
Yeah. Vincent Strong Cassell. Attack?
It's French.
Vincent Cassell has sex with Monica.
The only other movie that guy did was Silent Hill. That's all I can really remember.
That's a good movie.
And then the writer.
Wait, you mean Christoph Gantz? or whatever that guy's name is?
Yeah, Chris Dahl.
Yeah, yeah, he's the guy who did Silent Hill. And then, yeah. I forget the writer, same writer as Beowulf in Pulp Fiction. He was like the sub-writer. He ended up murdering.
Right, I haven't seen Interview with the fucking...
That's Brotherhood of the Wolf!
Yeah, Joel, stop
embarrassing. He has a sword made of bone that turns into a whip.
What?
Made of bone.
That's cool. A French movie.
Makes no sense.
And it's a French movie.
Yeah, Vincent Cassel.
I went and saw the movie.
The it's King good. Of France.
Viewers, you're pretty much into this.
So what are we talking about?
Sorry, I got off.
Yeah, well, that's gonna happen.
Regardless, this was gonna be our first live stream, so hopefully by the time this thing airs, we'll do our actual real live stream tomorrow.
Tuesday.
Hopefully.
Yeah, and then we move on Friday.
Tomorrow,
Tuesday.
Calendar man. I know. Tomorrow,
Tuesday.
You're ruining the magic. This video is going up on
Wednesday.
So tomorrow is
fuck.
Thursday.
Bingo. Yeah.
We'll stream for the first time on Thursday.
Nope. You're wrong. Tuesday.
Nice, Lawrence.
Good choice.
Nice.
Really fucking good at that.
Little Molotov cocktail.
Chop them down.
Yeah.
Square.
I'm not gonna waste items.
Watch that.
Fuck.
It helps if you pretend that they're just plates of grass.
So what are the topics of conversation for this podcast?
Bloodborne.
How about casual it is.
Bloodburn.
It's, I don't know.
So what are your observances? So
Hanukkah.
Passover.
Ramadan.
Well, so we have had a number of observances. One is that they're getting a lot better at environment design.
Yeah, more coffins.
Seriously, are you guys laughing at me for trying to make this podcast?
Oh,
okay.
No, there's more coffins than ever before. Yeah. If you're worried about
that PS4 tech is being taxed to the extreme.
I think that's,
if you were worried that next gen would mean less coffins for the Dark Souls franchise, you're wrong.
Torchman.
Because Torchman's bringing the coffins.
100 cobbles per square foot of room.
It is.
We got metal coffins. We got wooden coffins. We got luggage just hanging out.
The Torchman.
Torch. 94.5 Torchman and the Wolf.
I personally had issues with Dark Souls. I think
not enough coffins.
No, we all ooh blood echoes. Take those.
Nice. That's how it is.
That was so fucking hard to find.
How did he never find it?
Is that a blood stain?
It's actually a lot harder.
Oh,
to
go
see.
Back. You should go back.
Go
and
back.
Save.
Go back and level back the and fuck
save.
Up.
What? Oh, okay.
We're back inside.
That's only 1,000. That's not.
You can probably
you
get.
You can probably level up,
like
bro.
Like one stat point, I can get 20 more health.
All right.
So let him be good.
Anyway.
All right.
Once
I might
so
die.
We never got far enough in Dark Souls when we did our original drunk series. And we got to, I think the place is called like Anal Landing.
I got it.
Yeah.
Anor Londo, you Philistine.
Ooh, gotcha. It's not a
good one.
I mean, Lawrence, whatever.
Shit,
who cares?
Wrong. How do you. There we go. That's it.
We are discovering today that Bruce doesn't know who any of us are.
Absolutely not. Especially when I'm drunk.
You're like my you're my grandmother who thought I was a granddaughter for the first 8 years of my life.
Yeah, you know, pretty much.
I kept getting dolls.
Do you
and
have
I didn't
a penis
know
or vagina? Do you, I wasn't sure.
No, same thing, really.
Anyway, there are parts in Dark Souls where later the game becomes really fucking beautiful. It just took a while. We just didn't like the dank.
I'm gonna yeah.
Fuck. Oh, yes.
Fuck you.
Boom!
And I got shot in the back.
Shot in the back.
What the hell? Where did you come from?
Kaboom!
Good day, sir. Would you like to buy some wares?
Gunman!
The poor audio listeners.
I really
like,
feel bad
what
for the
audio. Happening?
No, they're all right.
Gunman and the crow.
Gunman, Torchman.
This is also where you got six drunk dudes in a room yelling at a Japanese video game.
Boom!
Oh, nice
that
shot.
Out.
That one guy lived.
That was really good.
Tale.
Oh, okay. How are you getting home tonight?
Yeah, how are you?
Dancing.
He's dancing home.
I don't understand the reference.
I wonder what Brittany thinks of that. Oh.
Don't bring it up. That's getting bleeped.
That's something I had to say.
Are you really going to make me edit this thing?
No, absolutely not. You leave it in.
All right.
You're kidding? I can fail. Leave that
There's
in.
Lots of B words out
thing
there.
There's a thing behind you.
Spool's never interfaced with a girl before, so.
Interface?
Interface?
That's not true.
Oh, wait, he had another
He's never butted with a girl.
There's all right.
Hold on. We're getting off topic here. Let's talk about Spool's love life. Spool, when was the last time your dick got wet?
Oh, Adam!
That is so rude.
I can make an inner butt joke, but you can't make a dick got wet.
I was talking about going to the pool, Joel.
This morning in the shower.
Thank you.
Oh, that's when you jacked off last?
He fucked some bitch in the shower.
Whoa, Spool!
No.
You got a shot. Watch out.
I was going to say, that's how you make a rated R joke, PG.
Good save.
That's not really PG, you can say dick.
Please go save. Can you save the game? Yeah.
What are you talking about?
You have 1,700.
He wants 10,000.
No.
1,700 is jack
shit. You're
going
to get Torchman.
Yeah, you got Torchman right then.
I don't know what
you see that guy? He's like, missed.
That's a...
Missed again.
That's John Rapier.
It's a hit like a little girl.
What'd you say?
John Rapier.
Oh, okay. All right.
It's interesting. Your tech animations are fat.
Okay, real quick, for all our audio listeners, Joel just made a reference to something that you could only see visually.
Because apparently that's what we're doing on the podcast now.
Wait, is that that's an inner butt joke?
It's not true.
I'm so glad Joel.
Regardless,
never mind.
I'm anticipating the comments that this will either be the best or worst podcast we've ever done.
Well, as soon as I'm sorry. I've given up trying to corral these animals.
Worst podcast ever.
Really sorry, guys.
This podcast is brought to you by Torchman.
And
Torchman and the Broken Crew.
Gunman.
I am so sorry.
Anyway,
let's bring it back.
More Bloodborne.
Let's focus.
So it seems like.
Ooh, wow.
I'll say that.
You're about to die.
I'm getting double shot.
Get the fuck out of there and heal.
That's the wrong button.
Peyton Manning.
Triangle again, please.
There we go.
What's the guy shoot?
God damn it.
I don't want to take
his coach.
All right.
Yes. I'm his hype man.
What's the next topic?
Oh, shit,
there's
that's a
dog behind you.
Next topic?
All right.
Are we done talking about Bloodborne?
No, we're not done, actually. So, the interesting thing about Bloodborne... fuck me.
Keep talking.
Is that,
You got a triangle again.
Your attack animations are pretty much faster than any enemy, so you can basically roll up to anyone, attack them, and you will stager them.
Thus far.
Yeah, thus far.
Until you get to a boss, and your shit gets pushed in.
Well, but... The thing with these games is that bosses have always just kind of... trumped whatever you do.
Yeah.
Like, they have, like, four animations, and they just cycle through those animations at random, and then if you happen to dodge or survive, then you can.
Well, it's just straight Mega Man. You learn the patterns of any enemy on the stage to the boss, then you have to learn the boss's pattern, and then once you learn the boss's pattern, you can beat the boss.
Is part of the challenge of this game not having a mini-map or knowing where you're going?
No, not at all. I feel like they do a good enough job laying out the map and the environment design to give you spatial awareness.
So here...
I am.
Here's
I'm working my way there.
Here's a little...
I want to get more blood vials on my way, though.
Here's a crash course for you, Joel, as a filthy casual. Mm. You end up replaying the same part so many times... You just memorize.
It's Mega Man. Yeah. It's exactly the same thing.
Like the old
Why aren't we any further than we were before?
Yeah, that's a great question.
We're further back because we're not
saving.
We're grinding right
we're
now.
We're not saving.
Well, there is no saving.
Something
there's
a save
somewhere,
but
sorry, that was my bad. I was distracted.
Less casual than now, that's
but you see, I got some life back. You saw that?
I did,
you didn't see that.
Very little bit.
If it was more casual, there'd be more saves.
So here's my favorite part. Lawrence just did the best thing in the world. He apologized. He said, "I'm sorry." I remember watching a bunch of Dark Souls walkthroughs, and they were like pros. I remember the guy, you know, remember Epic,
nothing there, Lawrence.
Epic Name Bro?
No, there's
he's
nothing
like
there.
The most popular.
Yeah, that guy's
Dark
awesome.
Souls. Yeah, he's great.
He actually explains Dark Souls lore in a way that I can appreciate.
He's a cool dude. He was he was like a Japanese school teacher, much like your brother, James. Maybe he's your brother. That'd be
boring.
Weird. Regardless, I do remember him. It was very like mistress-like, where he was like, "I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to get hit there. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry." And he was like, "You don't have to apologize, man. It's a hard fucking video game." But like, it is a strange thing. So like, Spool, beat Dark Souls 2, right?
One.
Just one. Okay.
With a trainer?
Now.
No, I just did it.
How many nights did it take?
Now he had the help of the internet.
So I had the internet's help.
That's
K-N-I-G-H-T? S?
T-U-B?
Brittany?
No.
So this
sorry, I apologize.
This brought up an interesting discussion, because a lot of people kept trying to give us tips. Remember when we played Dark Souls?
Yeah.
And they were like, "You should do this. You should do this." And we were all saying, "How the fuck do you know how to do that unless someone already tells you?" So that was the whole thing. I don't like to play games like that. I like to experience it for the first time by myself. And people are like, "Oh, you can't play Dark Souls that way."
Yeah.
I was like, that's kind of bullshit.
Yeah.
I knew that no one's online. And it was evil.
We'll see.
And so I was like, "Please, give me as many hints as possible. I want to get to this game as fast as possible. I know it's going to be hard. The mechanics are hard by themselves, so I don't need to, like...
This guy wants me first.
He's so tall.
Where, like, this secret...
No. Oh, that's my helper.
This secret...
Go
to the bad guy.
Yeah, let's
go. No, not him.
Yeah.
He's worthless.
No, go get him.
What are you doing?
That's your co-op buddy.
Yeah, but he's gonna run away.
Co-op buddy.
Go kill the big dude.
He's following me. Yeah, let's go fuck the boss.
Go fuck the boss.
Is it up here? It's up here, right? Yeah, that's an actual player.
Sorry, Spool, we totally cut you off because we're being drunk and belligerent.
Fuck him, kill him.
Help us.
He's weaker than you.
He's not helping you.
There we go.
Man, he's so big. Why weren't we that tall?
Boy. That's what she said.
Alright, here we go.
Nope.
Malta.
I'll wait until this is over.
Is he an NPC?
He seems AI-like. Yeah, I think
what?
I agree.
He's just following
Shit.
You.
I hit a dog.
Let him do that.
Holy shit! Uppercut!
He's so much better at the game than us, and he's...
Joel left.
Sorry. All right.
It's all right, Joel.
We love you.
You got things to do.
Brittany, my voice cracking.
Oh, you gotta stop that.
Shut
man.
Up.
I mean, what? I didn't mean to say that. Look, you guys, it's obvious she's listening. So is like Katie Bacon and Turbin.
Katie Bacon.
I love Turbin. I love Turbin just like I love Katie Bacon, just like I love Brittany. I love them all.
Take that
once
back.
Again,
I mean, I only love Katie Bacon and Turbin.
This is a rare what look that you guys get to see us all be drunk, where we're not very good at doing a podcast.
Not that rare for me, to be honest.
I stream this. It's a rare listen.
I stream this stuff like 3 times a week.
Yeah, that's your own.
That's a rare level.
I don't know how long you got this guy, so go. Also, you didn't save. You're gonna lose all those souls.
Who cares? You'll get them.
Go to the.
All that
find
work.
Find a save point.
No, can you wait? No, no. Use
there's
the,
gotta be a save around here.
Use the item real quick to go back to Hunterstown.
Who cares?
Kaboom!
Oh man!
He's not doing any damage, by the way.
He's distracting him though.
Nice dodge. Good dodge.
But what I was saying was, I was more than happy to have people guide me and like tell me to like go get this armor. It's the best armor.
What's up? Fuck! Dodge again.
I'm out. I was out of stamina.
I still died thousands of times.
Use the pebble.
Don't use the pebble.
Yeah,
it's not intuitive. It doesn't lead you or guide you anywhere. It's like, no, you should go back.
Like a real video game.
Get the fuck out of there.
I'm gonna die.
You're gonna die.
I'm gonna die really hard.
You also got silver bullets. Use stagger the fucker.
Pedal. Silver bullets.
That's the wrong bullet.
Boom, fire. Good hit.
Go get him. Go get him.
No, not worth it.
Good hit.
What?
Clean hit.
I went through a shit ton of bullets.
Boom.
No
combo.
Shit.
Nice dodge.
Good dodge.
That was a good dodge.
Sorry, podcast listeners. Joel made me very self-conscious about this.
Get him!
Get over here!
Help
save me!
What
help
are you
me
doing?
Man.
Ow! Ow!
You're gonna die! You're gonna die! You gotta turn! You gotta heal!
Oh,
you gotta
heal! Heal.
You gotta heal!
You gotta heal!
You gotta heal!
What is happening? Alright, he got you.
Search the corpse.
He's still alive!
Kill him!
Fuck!
Help him out, Lord!
Vial! Hit the fucking vial!
No, it's alright, it's alright, it's alright.
Three vials!
Lord, it's so
got it. Got it. Heals. I gotta use them all.
He's like, what?
Alright, go back to go back to Hunterstown.
No!
Hunterstown!
No!
Level up!
No!
You will never have that many souls again!
You need to find the save!
That's alright.
It's past the boss!
That's alright.
Please go to Hunterstown, please!
That's alright. It'll be okay.
It won't be.
Oh!
He's not even aware of the guys that are around him right now.
Oh, there's maybe something down there?
Yeah, look at this. I'll go find a lot of items down here.
Please be a save. Ooh, that guy's scary.
It will not be a save, I promise. Nice! There was a guy there! Holy shit!
Let me hit you.
Wow.
Woo!
That sickle guy was an asshole.
So what were you guys talking about?
Sorry, we got completely distracted by
I don't remember anymore.
Oh, shit! Kill him!
We really don't want to.
I will say, based on that reaction, this game does do a great job of having things pop out. At
it's exactly the same, man. Like, they know what they're doing.
Yeah.
It's got jump scares.
Not really jumps.
There must be an enemy behind that thing. Why is he going? He's going apeshit on that wall. No? Okay.
Sure.
I hate walls.
You can help me with the boss.
The game.
He's going to die immediately. You were saying, Adam.
The game is a lot like Dark Souls. People say, it's for filthy casuals. I don't know, they like, it's different, but it's the same. Like,
yeah, there's a little different texture to it. I would say that, they actually took away some of the liberties you have in terms of character creation. Like, you start with basically the same character, and they do that so they can more tightly constrain the actual fighting mechanics of the game.
Right.
It seems a little more like to beat 'em up versus an action RPG, which I'm totally fine with.
So when you say that, because like we did the no today, and we were talking about how you brought up Bayonetta, and I'm sure some people are gonna be like this guy is an idiot. He thinks it's like Bayonetta when that's not what we were saying at all.
No. I'm not saying this is like Ninja Gaiden, but I am saying Bloodborne is closer to that sort of game than it is to Demon's Souls.
Thus far,
using the Dark Souls
thus far,
control scheme.
You mean we did the no on Monday?
I'm sorry. Well.
Whatever.
Man,
hey there, buddy.
Just to clarify.
Any chance.
Yeah, Torchman.
Torchman is. Well, fuck you.
He is
you.
The best. You don't have to fight.
Boom. Dead.
This ghost man's almost dead.
Yeah, he's
how do you
almost
know?
Dead. You can see his life when he gets hit.
There's no way he's a
Use him as much as...
No, he's a meat shield. He's AI controlled.
He's totally AI.
I got no problem. This is not a human
being. If it was a human being, he would have ran off.
My eyeball went away. What's that all about?
I don't know what that
There's
means.
There's nothing in there, Lawrence. Go get the boss.
Maybe that's how many enemies are in there.
See if you can just open this stuff.
Oh, yeah. You're going to lock it from behind.
You got a pebble. Nice.
Yes, and this is going to take you back to your save point.
Hey, you found a save point.
Look
that's
at that.
That's the same save
Look
point.
At that. I found a shortcut.
Oh, yes. Oh. Thank God.
It's almost like I've played these games before. I know what I'm doing.
No, but you haven't played this game
Lawrence,
before.
Lawrence, did you beat any of them? Did you beat any of them?
No, actually, I haven't beat... Well, no, wait, I beat Demon Souls. I beat Dark Souls 1.
The first.
Oh, okay.
Lawrence, like, I've never beaten any of these games.
I mean, Demon Souls, Dark Souls 1, Dark Souls 2, and the other game from From Software called Mecha Hawk or whatever.
No, I beat Enchanted Arms, which is one of the few...
All right, talk to the puppet.
All right, fine. It's one of the few games that...
They do put a... Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, I see.
They put in a Japanese sex doll.
How many do you have?
I would say shrank,
skill.
Right?
You should level up skill.
Yeah. Based on what knowledge?
Blood and tinge? What is that?
Character's name, Harry Cooper.
Skill. Attribute governing more nuanced physical weapon attack. Determines whether or not you can use certain equipment.
Too many words!
What's that in strength?
Strength is,
What about your life? Is it vitality?
Endurance, yeah. HP is vitality.
Endurance is stamina.
Blood tinge.
So what are you gonna put? Don't yawn. Stop insulting our culture, Bruce.
No, it's boring.
Culture. Okay.
Bruce is right. It's
power of our can attack.
Games that kick our ass.
Joel left. Back.
No, Joel's been.
Does strength give you more DPS? It doesn't say that. It just says whether or not
you can use a
physical weapon attack.
Spend those points.
What skill? Every damage?
No, I'm selecting it right now. That's
wait, hold on. No, attribute selected.
There we go. Okay, so yeah, that does raise my.
You can only. Okay, so wait, you're.
And it raises my defense too. Look at that.
All right, so strength. Strength's sure. Probably the best, all right?
Strength and
endurance.
Health? Endurance health? Is good. Yeah.
Fuck health. I mean,
you'll never die. You're gonna live forever. You're a glutton.
Okay, I can get 2 more points of strength.
Do it.
Okay, nice.
Thank you, Sexol.
You're welcome.
All right. Let's go to the boss.
Like really? You have to click on him and press leave.
You have 1,800.
I got a lot of pebbles.
Ha! Yeah, take that.
Good talk.
Floor.
Ha!
I didn't even go anywhere.
Oh, look at that skyline, though.
Nice catch there, oh, Blinko. So cool.
It's like a hunter's trick.
I bet there's a lot of lore about why those things are there,
keep
huh?
Keep going.
Let's keep this going to the audio listeners.
We did watch the opening cutscene, the Bloodborne. I don't think any of us know what the fuck
beautiful.
The story is.
We skipped part, but
there's a lot of lore. A lot of lore there.
It's one of those things that made me want to play the... No, it didn't make me want to play the game.
I have actually given credit to Dark Souls and other games like that because they do just cut the filler out.
Yes, like, it's the Bungie approach. Like, the game is for the people who want to play the game. If you want the story, read the fucking flavor text on the items.
Which is
go to Bungie.net and read all the stuff. Stupid cards.
I don't need a David Cage, whatever life simulator of like shake the milk, and I'm just like this is sad.
Yeah, but sometimes those have shower scenes in them.
Ooh, Ellen Page Dipple.
Yeah. I'm with Spool on this one. Shower scenes, A+, for the win.
It's a video game about
shower scenes.
God of War had a 3-way minigame.
There's a way. There's a way to find shower scenes integrated naturally into a video game.
I agree.
How do you do that?
Wait. Like you press X
one?
And then they're naked.
Yeah, you go
to
that scene right there.
Was it this one?
Yes.
It's the same fucking game.
It's the same as Dark.
Where's your body? There will be a shortcut to the boss fight if you explore properly.
In their defense, if they made anything other than the same fucking game, people would be irate.
Well, that's the thing though. From Software until just now. Made a lot of different games.
Ring the Reckoning Bells.
They didn't rename everything.
He doesn't have any more Reckoning Bells.
They made a game about mech combat. They made a game about card-based strategy RPGs.
Really?
They made a game about, they made a game about, like, slow-paced strategic mech warfare.
Did you ring it?
Get up in there.
I did ring it.
Go fight the boss.
I think I already rang it too much.
You can buy more.
Ring it more.
You could have bought more clothes. You didn't do that.
It says unlimited use.
Use insight to ring and
anyway,
call.
So going way back to what I was talking about.
Oh, the eyeball is insight. I used my insight to summon a thing.
Oh.
Sorry, Adam.
Now you're done. You have
no, it's
insight.
Okay. I was talking about earlier how we were going to live stream, but there was an embargo.
Yep.
I think.
That's a bad guy.
Embargoes. Embargoes are lame, especially when you get a retail copy. Nice.
Right.
Yeah,
right
through the stomach.
It's all right. I got most of my life back. See that?
Yeah.
See that?
I was gonna say I think the one thing Sony probably didn't want people to see is the long load times.
That's probably the only negative I could really give the game right now.
And they're actually not that long.
It's
not
too bad. It's enough time to take a shot.
If you're a PC user and you're used to solid state, it's long. But if you're a console user, the load times are not that bad.
Yeah, I do hope the game comes to PC because these load times are pretty.
Okay, you can defeat the boss. This is
well,
it.
Isn't there a rumor that it's
I have three healing items?
You can defeat the boss, Lawrence.
There are a few rumors.
There was a leak.
Yeah,
supposedly that
Amazon France here. Listed the game on PC. Amazon France, man, those guys leak everything.
Thanks, France.
Pebble.
Nice, three damage.
That
nice.
Poor
Pebble
fucking bird.
He's like, oh. No, he's gonna slot.
You just hit that disabled crow.
I'll give you another one.
You asshole!
Oh, yeah. Why don't you
you're the hero that everyone needs in Bloodborne.
Like, I'm coming.
Throw rocks at animals.
Oh shit!
Uh-oh. I was gonna say similar to like Titanfall, like exclusives in this lifetime, unless the game is specifically owned.
Oh, wow!
By Microsoft or Sony or Nintendo. It's nice. Going to be on every platform.
Yeah.
Like,
well, and this is published by Sony Computer Entertainment.
Well, this is going to be like a timed exclusive. So 6 months on PS4. And
yeah.
They're
a big guy.
Yeah. Like they'll self-publish
it. Said it, but like it's a guess.
I'm actually really curious what the numbers were for Dark Souls on PC because they kind of did it as like a pity fuck for Dark Souls 1. They were like, all right, a bunch of you signed a petition and you really want it, so here it is. We're not going to do true mouse and keyboard support because you need a controller because it's just doing X and A. Fuck it. Here's your game. And I think it sold. It had to have sold well because then the Dark Souls 2 release was like straight on PC. They're like, here it is. I think it was delayed like by a week. But the fact that they launched it on PC.
The first one required like a really big like kind of like user created mod pack too to like make it. So
yeah, the DS fix and a few other things, yeah.
That's
which
sick.
I'm sure all your little stream friends
which
told
most,
you about.
I mean, most PC players don't mind having to mod or like patch them or whatever, like use user
good
patches.
Luck out there, Lawrence.
God damn it.
Just, as long as they get to play it.
God
where
damn
it kind of sucks when it's only exclusive to.
I gotta have something.
Let's all
have something.
Let's all have a moment of silence.
Pebbles?
Oil urn?
Pebbles?
Oil? That's good.
Oil that covers the target when thrown. Ooh, if you throw the oil and then you throw the
Molotov
cocktail.
I'm out of Molotovs.
Oh, man.
I'm out of Molotovs.
Bruce is the only guy here wearing shorts.
Fire and not going. Pungent blood attracts beasts.
Oh.
Doesn't matter. There's no beasts.
You can't use
damn
it.
I don't have insight.
What about silencing blank?
Alright, I'm fucked. Whatever.
You
shot time.
You don't
want to
go level up now? Did you see those textures?
Take your time. No rush. There's no rush on this.
There's a lot of rush, though.
But you're stronger now.
Through his legs. Remember that.
Yeah.
Oh, you got hit right up. First thing.
He got you.
Wow, there's some slowdown with the bosses too.
Yeah, I'm actually that's one of my dogs.
That's the sad part, is because it's exclusive to it. You think it'd be as optimized.
Ow, shit.
Yeah,
I'm learning. I'm learning the timing window.
The game is running at like sub 30 frames a second.
Dodge.
Get the fuck out of there.
Oddly, it rewards you for dodging early, which is not something I'm used to with Dark Souls.
Yeah.
There nice.
Nice.
That was a good
this is also the first boss.
Yeah, we should be able
that
to beat
we
this.
Know
I still think he has a gimmick. We don't know.
No, well, there was like a stun animation Adam found.
That's a wave.
I don't know. I mean, this was very similar to Dark Souls in the sense that it's like
dodge.
Dodge and get really close to him and dodge.
Yeah.
That was the strategy we found
you
out
gotta
early
manage
on.
Your, shit, that was
that was a tough one. That was
yeah, apologize.
Gotta get my. I'm so sorry.
Dodge.
I'm sorry, Mistress. Throw a pebble at him.
It's interesting though, because when you get hit, you definitely want to get in and hit him again before your red health goes away.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's an interesting mechanic.
Well, like Bruce was saying, it's like, so the weapon in your right hand, you can switch to either like.
Dodge.
Yeah, nice. Like,
well, right now, so yeah, it's in long form.
Nice move. Nice move.
It's like heavy and light. Or like heavy and quick.
So you can switch it to light, which it doesn't do as much damage, but it's much faster.
That one's fast.
Damn.
There we go.
Chop him. Get him. He's got so much endurance.
He's gonna come in real fast here.
Yeah.
He's just gonna.
Oh
wait.
Did he hit himself?
Yeah, it looked like it.
Good for him.
He's upset. Frustrated.
How'd
that hit me?
I
hit circle.
You might want to vial.
Yeah.
Two vials left.
And also, was it Spool? You were noting, on like the Estus flask, you.
Nice.
You heal much faster.
What the fuck?
Yeah, you heal super quick, but it doesn't heal you for as much. I can't.
Right.
It seems like it only heals you for
but
like,
then,
maybe
like
a third.
Well, like Lawrence was saying, the enemies don't seem to do as much damage as they used to.
Uh-oh.
Oh, yeah, that's always
more,
fun.
A lot more punishing. Like that in Dark Souls.
He didn't hit
you,
Lawrence.
Because he jumped
good.
Right on
that
your
really
head.
Good.
You would have died.
Fuck.
Oh, that old boy does
one
a good
one.
Get some of it back. Oh, I'm dead.
And we're shooting.
All right! Drunk Souls!
Oh.
I mean, Drunkborn!
Spool,
win a video game for us.
Okay, here we go.
Does that mean I have to take a shot?
You're the fish. Who's
this? This is yours, right?
No, this was James.
That's Adam's.
This is mine. No, sorry. Wait. Who's I Love Los Angeles?
That's cool. Yeah. I'll figure this out.
Things are starting to blur.
Yeah.
Drunkborn. Drink Drabble Burns.
Cheers.
Yeah. Oh, who would I miss?
Nobody.
Okay. Drunkborn.
So I'm figuring it out. Despite what I said at the beginning of the game, I don't think it's casual garbage. But I do think they are figuring out a way to make the Demon's Souls formula of gameplay a little more approachable.
It's almost like they finally finished that game that they started all those years ago.
See, FromSoft has never been a AAA complete game developer. They come up with a cool idea, they fucking crank it out, and they push it out. It's almost like the Beatles, right? Like, and that's a weird thing to say, but game every year. And it's only after Demon's Souls, when they started getting a budget and acclaim, that they took more than a year to make a game.
That the Beatles experimented and changed. Whereas turned out like a better version of the same game. This is the fourth version of the same game.
Well, that's because it's the first time they've actually been monetarily successful. Okay. I mean, if you go back to Kingsfield, the same ideas are there. He's got to figure out the buttons.
You have no help.
Just don't go to the boss.
Just make sure you apologize every time you die.
You definitely want to...
Torchman!
Well, you got to give me time to fill up these shot glasses before you die.
Please don't die.
Oh, it hurts so bad.
Well, if you die right now, I'm gonna take it away. And I'm gonna give it to Adam.
Should I view the notes?
I don't want to play again. It's painful.
Anyway.
That's heavy. No one wants heavy attack.
So From Software is one of those developers, kind of like Team 17 or Intelligent Systems. Like, they've just been quietly making games for about 20 years. And it's really weird to me that,
there's
two of them. Holy shit. Yeah, like, they've just suddenly been thrust into the limelight. And it's like, you suddenly are making, like, looked forward to games with, like, crazy money. And it's been really interesting to see them scale up in terms of production.
Well, Demon's Souls was the sort of, like, it was a very Japanese game.
Yeah.
But it came at a time where I think people were getting a little... What the fuck?
Whoa. Fuck that dude up! He's got a gun.
Say it, old man.
He killed a handicapped man.
Nice.
He gave me
It came out at a time. I'm trying to place the time. So 2009, right?
Yeah, it was 2010 ish. Let me look.
I want to say it's 2009. So we don't sound like it. Got it. I think it was probably 2008 Japan. Push down on the right. You know how to fucking do it. Lock on. Do it.
It's been a while.
Now I'm starting to experience what other Dark Souls players get, where I'm
when
like,
they get mad at you.
Yeah, what the fuck is he doing? Play it right.
Come on.
Which you do not watch Funhouse to get people playing video games correctly.
You're at the boss, by the way. You have to beat these bad guys.
No, we don't do pro game.
I want to say Demon's Souls came out.
Why did you do that?
Go back in the sewer.
I'm trying to change.
Why are you throwing a pebble?
I'm trying to change pebble.
Spool, go to the sewer.
2009.
I'm trying to change pebble to something useful.
So I'm trying to place it in my brain. 2009, like, so 2007 was this weird sort of. Oh god.
Well, Adam, I feel like what you're getting at. There's a larger commentary on game development, really. 2009 was smack in the middle of, we're making AAA games like movies. Pretty much all of the 360 PS3 generation was, we want our games to be as much like movies as they possibly can be. And that led to games like Mass Effect and Gears of War, which I give Gears kind of a pass because it actually had some mechanics to it.
The heyday of Gears of War, Mass Effect, Call of Duty, and Halo.
Yeah.
And Assassin's Creed.
And Uncharted, don't worry about Uncharted.
And
Uncharted.
Yeah, and so, God of War. These were the sorts of games.
Heavy Rain. And to a lesser degree, BioShock.
So Demon's Souls was kind of a breath of fresh air.
Demon's Souls was a total throwback, and everybody...
Nice, good throw.
Everybody was like, oh, wow, there's a game that, like, has no cutscenes. It's entirely, like, original Legend of Zelda style.
You got both.
They just drop you in a world, you have to run around and figure this shit out on your own, and if you don't, you have to ask your friends.
Keep going.
And that was one run.
Not like that.
And it's ultra punishing.
Yeah, and it's ultra punishing, it made you accountable.
I'm trying to find a run.
And, I think...
Hold down circle, you fuck.
Demon's Souls...
Hit that lever.
...was, it actually emboldened a lot of other developers.
Wait,
really?
I
want to murder you so much right now.
Okay.
Stop throwing the fucking rocks!
Turn around.
Stop it!
Turn around.
Price is in use.
For the sake of the stream, Spool is trying to pull a lever, but he keeps throwing rocks.
It keeps saying you can't use it! Why would you keep trying to use it if you can't use it?
Because I thought I was hitting the
wrong
button.
Oh.
So.
Look around.
There's nothing in the goddamn coffin.
To the right. Personally. Stop destroying things.
Sorry.
Oh my god.
Personally, I felt like game development in the 7th, I think it is, the Xbox 360 PS3 generation. Nope. Yeah. All those games are kind of lost. Like, I feel like they're kind of the 80s movie style of game, where it's like, we're going to throw so much money at this, and we're going to make it the ultimate game. And what they ended up doing is making a movie style game that's really not a game. And I feel like in 20 years, people are going to go back and play them, and they're going to be the campy Mystery Science Theater bullshit that they deserve to be. Yeah.
Well, but, it's the sort of thing where I think
from the other side. Go back.
I think
go up the stairs.
No.
Are you trying to get back to the
same
boss?
Place? No. Absolutely.
Okay,
no.
Never mind.
You can go back there and go up to the right.
Ah, you want to get healing? You can probably go back.
This is the worst or best podcast we've ever done.
Jesus Christ!
So
it's hard being drunk and self-aware.
Demon's Souls about a game I've never played.
Was one of the weird bright beacons where it's like, we're gonna make a video ass video game. And it resonated with a lot of people because they were starved for that, even though they didn't know it.
Yeah.
Turns out you play video games to hit buttons and interact. You don't play a video game to put your controller in your lap and watch a fucking cutscene that's really poorly written and poorly acted.
Well, like sort of the...
Uncharted is decently written and decently acted. But I mean, like,
is
other...
Is it Nolan North?
Yes.
Everything has a price.
Yeah. It's not out.
Anyway.
Sorry, goddamn. Well, I was going to say, it was... Video games,
you suck.
Or I guess like any sort of entertainment, it's like what Bruce is always saying. People want something new and different.
Don't judge me.
But they don't know what that is typically.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's a weird thing.
They
like,
do though. I mean, people resonate with certain kinds of games, like Wii Sports sold the Wii, and there's a reason for that. It's because it was really snappy and it showed people an experience they hadn't felt before.
It was different but familiar.
Ooh, yeah, exactly. Like everyone knows baseball. Everyone knows how to swing a baseball bat. You put a Wii remote in somebody's hand and you're like, just swing. And they swing and their guy on screen hits the baseball and it has a cool like baseball sound and everybody's cheering and they're like, this is really cool. And then they go and spend $250 and buy a Wii. And it becomes their Wii Sports machine.
Idiots.
That's fine.
There's nothing in them.
Fall out of that window. You're going to get a sweet item.
Don't do that.
No.
It's not that far of a fall.
But
turn around and go down the stairs.
For a lot of people that were reared on like really core, like interactive-based, skill-based games, Demon's Souls, for the span of about 5 years, was the first game that came out that actually prioritized those virtues.
Yeah.
So
next to like Mega Man 9.
Yeah. Mega Man 9 and 10 were kind of a similar story.
Yeah. Both came out around similar times.
It's not a surprise to me that there's a certain sect of gaming that has like vaulted from software under their shoulders, because in a time where every developer was trying to make a movie-based game, they were basically the only ones saying, no, we're going to make a video game. Mm-hmm. We're going to make one that like allows the player to discover things on them on themselves, and allows them to express their skill in the world.
Oh, fuck the guy.
And actually holds them accountable for having to learn patterns and express that back.
Heal, you fuck.
I'm healing!
Can't take another shot right now. I don't think you needed to heal twice.
Nice shots. What's up?
I wanted to heal.
Watch out for the gun. Well,
it's alright. He can glitch through objects.
Gun guy.
You can't.
So, listener, because we are about to segue into show and tell, listener, if you are on the fence about Bloodborne, it is more but different, which is probably what you're looking for.
Yeah.
It seems a little easier than Dark Souls.
I guess, so...
It at least seems like it doesn't fuck you in the ass at the very beginning of the game and make you never want to play it.
Yeah.
It's like, we'll ease you in, and then I'm assuming later on in the game it's going to fuck you in the ass.
And ideally, obviously we name dropped...
The first boss fucks you in the ass.
We name dropped Epic Name Bro, because we're aware of guys who you'd probably go to first for their opinion on these sorts of things.
We got it.